In Chinese, there are three very classic, de, 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 and in this video, we are focusing on de. The characters de in Chinese doesn't have direct words in English. The most basic and commonly used sentence structure is this. Verb or adjective plus de plus description. In this structure, the word before de are mostly action words. And the word after de describes the state of the action, indicating how is it. It seems like we are answering the question, how's the action, includes the degree, result, or state of the action. Let's look at the three common sentence structure with de. Verb plus de plus description. Usually we describe the result or degree. Verb plus de plus description, sometimes we describe the state of the verb. Adjective plus de plus degree. The first sentence structure is mostly used to describe the result or degree of an action. For example, before every each online class, I always heard students asking me, 你听我吗? Or 你听到我吗? Which means, could you hear me? If we modify the sentence, 你听得到我吗? Is the correct way. According to the sentence structure, we just talk about verb plus de plus result or degree. In this case, 听 is the action, and 到 translated as to or get is the result generated by action of 听 here. Here are a few more examples. 他写字漂亮。他写字漂亮。 In this case, the action is 写, write, and the result is 漂亮, beautiful. So the common Chinese expression is 他写得漂亮 to replace 他写字漂亮. 我哥哥跑很快。我哥哥跑很快. To describe the degree of running in this sentence, we can use the sentence structure. 我哥哥 跑得很快, making the expression more natural. The second sentence structure, the character de connects an action with the resulting state caused by that action, emphasizing the specific state resulting from the action. For example, when you just arrive in China and you want to tell mom that everything is fine to avoid worrying her, you may say, 我在中国一切都好, I'm doing great in China. 吃得饱, eat well. 睡得好, sleep well. Even mom can't understand Chinese. Or when you're hiking with friends and you've been walking for a long time, feeling a bit tired and want to take breaks, you may say, 我爬山累了,我们坐一会儿。 I'm tired from walking, let's sit for a while. If you say that, you made a mistake that students always make. Instead, we could say, 我走得累了,我们坐一会儿。我走得累了,我们坐一会儿. In the sentence, 走得累, 累, tiredness is the condition resulting from the action of walking, 走. So we add 得 in the middle of express is more natural. The third sentence structure is used to emphasize the degree of state described by the adjective. For example, 高兴地跳起来。高兴地跳起来. In this case, the state of 跳起来, jumping up, is caused by the adjective 高兴, happy. 累得快死了。累得快死了。Here, the state of almost dying, 快死了, is describing the degree of the adjective tired, 累. But sometimes students, after learning the expression 死了 to convey an extreme situation, tend to say 累得死了, tired to death. I mean, this expression is not quite appropriate in Chinese. Under the sentence structure, adjective plus de plus degree, we must describe the degree or state. 死了, to die, is more of a result. So it's not suitable in this context. A more fitting expression could be 累得快死了 almost dying, or 累得要死了 nearly dying. The above is a brief explanation of 得, hoping it will helpful in your future learning. I've listed some common daily expressions for you to practice and improve your language proficiency. 跑得快，跑得快。听得懂，听得懂。学得会，学得会。看得见，看得见。做得好，做得好。吃得饱，吃得饱。飞得高，飞得高。走得远，走得远。说得轻，说得轻。玩得开心，玩得开心。高兴的跳起来，高兴的跳起来。高兴的笑了出来，高兴的笑了出来。累得不行，累得不行。气得说不出话，气得说不出话，气得火冒三丈，气得火冒三丈。干净的一尘不染，干净的一尘不染。忙得不可开交，忙得不可开交。糟糕的无法形容，糟糕的无法形容。Personally opinion, I just recommend students to read this phrase, just to get to use the speaking way in Chinese. And thank you for watching these videos. See you next time.